Joining me now is Emmerson Resources Managing Director Rob Bills. Good to have you back, Rob.
Thanks very much, Elisha. It has been a while.
Rob, Emmerson has just released its quarterly results. Walk us through what's happening at your projects. We'll start off with the work ongoing at Hermitage.
Yes, look, this is really exciting. I think, we've made some terrific progress this year. You might recall last year we announced our discovery hole, 114 metres at 3.4% copper and 0.88 grams per tonne gold. So that was ranked as one of the highest grade copper intersections in the globe at the time in 2022. So what we've done this year, Alicia, is gone back and done a phase two drilling. So what we did was we extended that original discovery hole. And unfortunately for us, we discovered that there's a fault that cuts off the mineralization at depth. So the hole went down a bit further and then we hit a fault. So the rest of the drill program were inclined holes coming in from a different direction. So we completed that program. We've announced two lots of visual results from that program, ASX visuals. The first one was a new zone of copper mineralization in drill hole Herc number 5. So that's a new zone of copper that we found outside of the main body. So the assay results are pending on that one. And the big result again was we turned the rig around and we drilled from the other direction. So we actually turned around and we drilled through the fault out the other side into copper mineralization. Now, the visual results are very impressive. We've got copper up the top of that hole, malachite grading into native copper and then into chalcopyrite. But we hit a visible gold zone just before the fault. We went through the fault and we hit further copper. So suggests that obviously the copper continues beneath the fault at depth, which is obviously a big step forward in terms of, you know, increasing the resource potential. So still waiting on the results there. It's been a bit of a frustration, I must admit, and the whole industry suffered from it in terms of the turnaround times at the laboratory, but we are expecting those results in a couple of weeks' time.
Looking out now at your Mauritania project, what's been going on here during the quarter?
So we announced a mineral resource estimate, Alicia. So that's a JORC compliant resource of about 40-odd thousand ounces at 3.5 grams per tonne. That goes with a previous one we announced last year, Chariot, which was about 139,000-odd ounces. So the strategy there is to build a pipeline of resources, gold resources, and they are what we will get a 6% gold production royalty from. So essentially what happens there is we make the discoveries when they're in the joint venture ground. They go into a thing called a mining joint venture. Our joint venture partner then takes those discoveries, proves them up, additional drilling, does a mineral resource estimate, all the metallurgy and whatever else pre-mining, puts it in a mining plan. And as you know, we're hoping that mill in Tennant Creek, arrives sometime this year and we start producing next year. So that's where we get our 6% gold production royalty from mining of those resources. So I think, the royalty model, the emerging royalty model, once those mines go into production, is starting to take shape. You'll see this pipeline of resources building over the period of the joint venture. So there'll be more and more resources get into that mining schedule where we get our 6% gold production royalty. And, as you know, that gold production royalty shields our investors from both the capital expenditure and operating expenditure of building those mines and, and doing the mining and processing. You might have seen some of the industry announcing, some of the producers announcing escalation in all-in sustaining costs of mining these things quite recently, and they've been marked down quite significantly, where the royalty model actually shields our shareholders from that. We purely and simply just get a 6% royalty on production. So those costs are all with our joint venture partner and not with Emmerson.
Rob, you and I recently spoke about how Emmerson was 3 for 3 on a grants funding program. Tell me, how is that result tied into your financials this quarter?
Look, it's a real feather in the cap. Testament, I think, to, you know, the systematic science-based exploration we do in Tennant Creek. You know, we're heralded as one of those companies that use a lot of technology and cutting edge techniques. So the granting of these 3 out of 3, as you say, from the Northern Territory Geological Survey, their co-funded collaboration grants, certainly helps financially, but it's a more of a feather in the cap in terms of testament to our exploration and the importance it has in the Northern Territory. So the first grant was around collaborating on our drone technology. So we've been flying drone aeromagnetics, which has been a real breakthrough for us up in Tennant Creek, because a lot of the gold is associated with magnetite, which is obviously magnetic. So getting high resolution data from a drone is a really big step forward. Previously, you have to use a fixed wing aircraft, obviously on much wider space lines and a lot further off the ground. So the resolution was nowhere near as good. So that's the first grant. The second grant is around drilling at our Golden 40 mine. So that's a great, it'll go directly into, step out drilling. And as I told you before, that's hopefully moving that into the mining schedule as we go forward. And then the third grant is around processing of the aeromagnetic data. So it's trying to get a bit smarter about how we process this data to pinpoint new deposits.
So Rob, first quarter of FY23 coming up, what should investors expect from the Emmerson camp?
Well, hopefully we get some great assay results, Alicia. If the visual results are any indication, we're expecting some pretty solid results out of Hermitage. And as I said, the first lot should flow in a couple of weeks' time, and then it'll continue on, because that was a reasonably long period of drilling, and they're all queued up at the assay laboratory. So that'll be the first and foremost thing. Second thing is, look, we're about to kick off a big drill program in the joint venture area in Tennant Creek on the Golden 40 mine. So that's, like I said before, trying to convert some residual resources there that were historic resources into a potentially large open pit gold resource. If that drilling's successful, that'll be fantastic. We'll expand, obviously, that the resource side of the business. And then outside of that, we've got obviously continuation of the drone magnetics in Tennant Creek. So we're flying a big program of drone aeromagnetics up in that northern project area. So that's over the existing joint venture tenements, but also over some of the 100% owned Emmerson tenements, the Edna Beryl area as well, where we've got a couple of historic hits there, where we hope that we might find similar mineralization to what we've drilled at Hermitage. We've got ongoing land access negotiations with the Central Land Council and the traditional owners on a project called Jasper Hills. And that's probably about 400 metres to the south of Hermitage. So it's a similar style of mineralisation to Hermitage. We'd love to dearly get in there and start our drill program. It's still going through the negotiation, but we're quite hopeful that, eventually we'll get access to that to drill test that area. And then, of course, we've got projects which we haven't talked much about over in New South Wales. We did a raising before Easter, so we're very well funded. So we're going to do a drill program over at a project called Keola, which is near Cowra. It's in the same kind of geological province as the big Cadia Ridgeway, the New Crestone Cadia Ridgeway copper gold deposit, and the Alkane Boda discovery. So we've used, again, some pretty innovative science in terms of picking up that ground at Keola and then moving it forward. So we've done a big 3D geophysical survey There's a lot of smoke on the surface. So if you go out there, there's, you know, copper and old workings and whatever else. And this is the first time that there's going to be any deep drilling. So at the moment, as you know, New South being very wet. So the farmers obviously don't want us to be dragging big drill rigs across their paddocks at this point in time. So that program, I think we can kick off later this year. And again, we got co-funding from the New South Wales government for that Keola drill program. So I think we're very well positioned.
We'll keep an ear out for those updates and for the latest results. Rob, thank you for your time today.
Thanks very much, Elisha. Always a pleasure.